Hello dear friends, welcome back to tutorial from the NXCAD. So today we will have the practice and design the Airpod using the NX. So in this tutorial you will learn how to use the trim sheet function, the studio surface function, revolve and extrude the features for the surface element. So let's open the new file here and here select the sketch and select the display, then press OK, and here the draw the rectangle from the center, this from the disk center, and draw the rectangle here, and let's define the dimension of the rectangle, and this side is the 4 millimeter, and this side is the 2 millimeter. So here we have this rectangle, and select here the arc here, arc common, and draw the arc here. This 2 points arc with the 3 points. So this one, it should be the tangent here. The same way this point, select this point and this point. Oh, so this point. So select here the arc, this point. In this point in the yeah, so here this should be the tangent, the arc with the rectangle. In order to check that it is tangent or not, go to the geometric constraint here, select the geometric constraint and select here the tangent. So select this one and this one. So yeah, there is already exists, so we need to be sure. So there are the tangents, so in the same way here, okay. And here also the fourth side is the tangent. Now we can close the geometric constraint, and here select the quick trim function and trim this side of the rectangle, two sides, and close the quick trim and finish the sketch. So here this is our profile. Now we need to create the plane, the datum plane. Here select the datum plane here, from the type select at a distance, and here the select as a reference the datum plane, this one, and you see that datum plane at a distance is started to create at a distance, but we will change this value to the 10 millimeter. So here, and we will change here the values only the one here. So we need only the one datum plane at a distance of the 10 millimeter from this reference one. So just the pressed OK to finish this one. So you see that the plane is created. Now we will draw here the ellipse in this new datum plane. In order to do this, select the sketch, select this datum plane, and double click to do this arrow to be directed on this direction. So press OK. So now let's draw the ellipse here, select the ellipse curve, and the starting points, specify the point is this one. You can select you can open here the point dialog, and here the 000 point, keep the 00 point, and this is the cursor location, and just press OK, and you see the ellipse start to create it, but we will change the values. Make the major radius is the 8 and the minor radius is the 5. Change it to the 5 and 8 here like this. So this is our minor radius, and this 8 is our major radius. So the angle keep is at 90 degrees, and just press OK here and they finish the sketch. So this is our ellipse. Now we will draw some guide course in order to create the surface elements. So in order to do this, again select the sketch. We will draw the guide course for the beginning this plane. So press this plane and press OK. And let's draw the arc here for the beginning, this kind of arc. So, and in order to be sure, you can a little bit move like this, and let's create some points using this function intersection point, select the intersection point, and we will create the point here and here, that's and here and here, in order to connect properly connect this arc with this our the section. So I will select for the beginning the, for example, this one. You see the point is created, and press the apply here, and I will this one, and here the point is created, press apply. The same way I will create here. So if the there is no point, just here the select this one, cyclic solution, and point will be the appeared here, and press apply here. The same way here, you see the point applied here, then press OK here. Now we created this one, and I will connect the this arc with the, this upper two points. In order to do this, I will use the geometric constraint. So select the geometric constraint and select here the coincident. In this case, I will for this right click here and select from the list, and here select the point or this one, yes. And select as a second point, this one. So they are the coincident. The same way, like to here, right click here, select from the list, and here the point. And as a second option, select this point. So they are the connected. Close this one, and we will define the radius of the, this arc, and just double click here, and define is a 11. So press enter and close this one. So and the same way we will create the arc here in the lower part. So go to the arc, so this point and this point just here. Now, the same way with the geometric constraint, let's make the coincident of the points of the, this one. So right click here, select from the list, and the point with the, this point, the same way here, right click here, select from the list, and the point, and this one. So close the geometric constraint and define the radius of the, this arc as well. So double click here and define is the 11, the same, press enter, close this one. So we created two guide course, so finish the sketch like this. Now we will create another two guide course on the this plane. So in the lower plane, in order to do this, select the sketch again here. So select the this plane, so just press OK. So the same way we will, for the beginning, we will create the intersection points here using the this intersection point. So intersection point of the this plane with the, these two curves for the beginning, they selected this one. So created here the point, apply, and the second side, so point created, apply here. The same way on the this one, so point is created here, apply, and this one, the point is created. Now we can, okay, just, so we created four points. Now we will create the arc on the this plane. So the same way, select the arc, the three points. So this point, just this point in here. So go to the geometric constraint and the coincident, right click here, select from the list point with the, this one, so it is the coincident. The same way, right click here, select from the list point here, and this point, so it is the coincident. So close this one. So let's define the radius of the, this arc, also the 11 here, press enter. So the same way we will draw the same arc on the, this side. We already create the points, intersection points. So we need just to create the three points arc here. This point and just this point, this. And using the geometric constraint, we will just make the coincident of the, these points with the arc. So I click here, select from the list, this point, so. So the same way, right click, so point and this point. So close the constraint, define the radius after this one as 11, just press enter. So we finished our the second guide course like this, then we can finish it. So we created our the profile. So it consists of the ellipse and this kind of shape, this is the sections, and we have the four guide course. So in order to create the surface using the these courses, we will use here the surface. We will go to the surface menu, and we can use the studio surface in order to create the surface using the these courses. So select the studio surface here. The as a sections for the section here, we'll select this one and the ellipse. So here we can select from the filter as a connected curve. So we will select this one. So this one is selected, and we will select here the add new set and select the ellipse here. So you see the direction is the different. So we will change the directions here. So in this case, now it's the direction the same. Now we will select here the guide curve. So go to the menu of the guide curve, and we will start to select here the our the for the guide course, which is the our the arc. So in this case, the, as a filter, we will go to the select here the single curve. So it should be important. It is the important. So single curve. Now we will start to select our the guide course step by step. So be careful with the dimension direction. So select this one. So here this one, and add new set, and select this one. So in this direction, always add new set, select the add new set, and so this one, so add new set. So then is the lower one, so add new set. So and last one, this one, to close this one. So now we can here the go to the setting and make it as a sheet element. So you see the surface is created like this. So now we can close this, just press the OK. So this is the how is the our system is obtained. Like this. Now we can do, we can continue. Let's select here the home tab. Here the select the sketch again, and select the this plane. So let's place this one, and let's open this one and make it select here the project curve, and convert the this select the this edge of the ellipse here to convert it to the active line on the this plane. So press OK. Let's draw the line here, select the line, simple line here. Go to the geometer constraint and make it coincident of the this line with the, this axis. So it is the coincident, and convert this line to the reference line, and using the quick trim, just the trim of the this part of the ellipse, only the this part. So this part will be still active. Just close this one and finish the sketch. So we have only the ellipse, half ellipse on the this part, in the lower part, you see, in the this part, because we trimmed the upper part. Now go to here and go to the sketch here, to the our the sketch, and here from the directly select the revolve function. So revolve, you see, it is the selected this half ellipse, and the select here the vector as a vector, this vector. So it is the revolved, started to revolve, and here as a center point, select here this one, the arc or ellipse center point, and select this arc here. So the alignment is the important, since that when your surfaces, if you look here, if alignment is not proper, there will be some gaps between the surfaces in the top and down here. So my advice to here to use the specify the center of the rotation, that this method, the arc, ellipse, the sphere at the center. So it will exactly define the center of the rotation. So here you can see the proper alignment between the surfaces. So now here we can define the angle of the rotation. So here it should be like this, only the half rotation. So we will write here the negative 180. So it is enough for us just to rotate in the half degree. So, and here we will define the body type as a sheet element. So, and just press OK here to finish this one. So this is the result after the revolve. So now we will continue with the, so in this case we will sketch again a new profile here, and we will select here the this plane. So let me cancel it here. So just a moment, like this. So proper position, and sketch again here, select sketch, select this plane, the axis is this one, and press OK here. So, and now sketch here the profile. So for the beginning, select the line here, and starting from this point, draw the vertical line, and and then continue this line, draw this kind of line here, and select the line again, and draw the line like this. Can change it to position, and draw the arc here, select the 3-point arc, and connect this point and this point with the arc like this. So now we will define some dimensions here, and the define the arc dimension, that's the radius is the 15. So, and close the rapid dimension, and select the geometric constraint, and make it here the point on curve, this point on the this curve. So, and rapid dimension again, and define that this is the 10 millimeter. Go to the geometric constraint and make it the tangent of this one. So select the tangent, this one with this one. So this should be the outside, so this should be outside. So let's delete this one, and let's make it move it, and this one also, and let's draw the line here like this. And there should be the outside here, not moving. So let's delete again here, and move it here a little bit outside. So, and connect these two lines. So we can finish the sketch. It is our the profile, and select here the extrude function, and select this one here, the connected should be the selective, so extrude it, and extrude that is symmetric extrude, and let's decrease the distance a little bit like this. So okay, just a moment, cancel it. Before the extrusion, let's unite the combine these two surfaces. In order to do this, go to the surface, select here the save function, and this one and this one, make it combine. So It is the combined, and let's here the sketch. Let's go down the this drag and go down to this sketch and go to the home tab and extrude it again. Now it works, since they should be the combined, so that's why I combined the two surfaces. Now let's make symmetric extrude like this. And from the boolean, select the subtract that will subtract from the disk surface. You see it is automatically selected, and just press OK here. So we will get such kind of figure like this. So we can hide this profile, the ellipse itself, and the plane here, and so on. This one also. So, and this one also. Now we will go sketch again, select the sketch again, select this plane, press OK here. So we will draw the circle for the beginning here like this. So, and let's define it is dimension of the circle is the diameter is 6 millimeter. So close the dimension. And let's define the dimension, the position that this one is the double click to this one and make it 12. Press enter. And this one is the 11. This one. So this is our the circle. That's the location that closed this one. And they finish the sketch and extrude this circle. Go to the extrude, so select here this one, change the direction, and select the starting point 5 millimeter limit, and the end limit is the 32. So here like this, from the boolean make it known. So and from the body type convert it to the sheet like this, and just press OK, so we obtain a such kind of system. Now we will connect these two elements. The two elements, this cylinder with this one with the studio surface element. So in order to obtain the shape, so in order to do this, select here the surface and select here the studio surface, you see. In this case, what we have to do here as a section, as a primary curve, we will select the this edge and this edge. So you see it is selected two curves. So and we will make it add new set, and as a second the primary curve we will select this circle. So be careful, it should be the same direction, since you see we have to change the direction like this. So it should be in the in this form. So now what we have to do here, we have the go down to the continuity. So we will here the change the continuity G0 from G1 and select this surface. You see it is selected here. You see two faces is selected. You can see from the hit axis on, and we will change here the second continuity is to the G1 and select this face, and we will here the in the flow direction change to the perpendicular. So you see the shape is obtained. So this the continuity is important, so be careful. G1 continuity with the upper face, and the second the last face, the last section G1 continuity with this cylinder one, and also the flow direction should be the perpendicular in order to obtain the such a proper shape like this. Now we will go to the here the body type. At the body type we will change it to the sheet metal and press OK. So you see that our proper shape is obtained for the airport. Now, what we have to do? So now we will continue with the other elements of the airport. We can hide this circle and this one also. So here we will draw the lower part here. In order to do this, we will create a new datum plane for the beginning. So at a distance, so go to the home tab, select here the datum plane, and from the type it should be at a distance, and select the display. So, and here insert the 11 at the distance and press OK here. So we will draw the sketch on this new datum plane. So select the sketch and select this datum plane. Just press OK here. And here in the lower part, we will draw the arc here. So select the arc, 3-point arc, and select this point, sorry, just the end point, and draw the such kind of arc here with the radius of 1 millimeter, or we can make it like this. So 1.3, like this. So the this one. So and now we will revolve it. Just select here the revolve, and as a axis of the this one, and as the from here the center point it is the use this one again, and select as a center point this one, so it is the revolved, but here it is the change it 360, so it is the revolved, and from the body type select the sheet, so and press OK. So you see it is obtained in the lower part. Now we will close this lower part using the boundary plane. So in order to do this, select the surface here, and from the more, select here the boundary plane and just select this edge. So in order to just here the gaps, maybe let's define here. So select here boundary plane, and here select just single curve, and select this one. So you see it is the closed, and press OK. So you see the lower part we created. Our the system, we can unite the combine them using the self function, since they are the sheet metal. So we use self for the combine this one with this one and this one. And this one also this one, all the parts, they combine them and make it here the body type, make it shell, sheet, and press OK. So that's OK. So here we combined them. Here you see the self function. Now we will here make some additional elements here. So we can hide this plane. Select the home here, and here create the new datum plane for the beginning in the distance, again at the distance of the 1 millimeter from the here. Let's check it from the top side. So it is the distance, so we can make it a little bit lower. 0.5 is enough, I think that yes, we can use the 0.5. just press OK here. So we create a datum plane here at a 0.5 distance. Now we will go to the sketch, select in this case this new datum plane which we created just now, they change the axis rotation here. It's okay. So here select the curve and go to the here the project curve. So I would like to projection of this edge onto this new datum plane. So I will select this one here. You see the curve is selected, and select here the object is this plane, this new datum plane. So we can check from here. We can select from this here. You see, I will show here from the part navigator. You see this datum plane, and here the direction of this axis. So you see this curve is projected here. So what I the project here, and just okay. So you see I projected this profile onto this new datum plane. Now I will extrude it, select the home here, the select here the extrude, and select this one. So it's reverse direction. Here the change limit value starting zero, and the extrude value will be the 0.5. Press enter, and the body type make it sheet, and okay. So you see, I obtained this surface. Now I will close this one using the boundary again from plane. So you know, to the surface from the more, select the boundary plane and select this one. This one, all the edges here like this. You see, it is the closet, and press OK. So here I obtained this one. So we can again save the this elements using the save function. This one with this one, apply. So this one with this one. Okay, so we made the combination of the surface elements. We can hide the this ones, the sketches, and the this ones. Now we will create here this one. We can also the hide this plane here. Now we will create the two circles on the this surface. So go to the home again, select the sketch, select this surface, press OK, and select the circle and draw the circle here exactly, and with the diameter of 1 millimeter. So you can mirror it here, mirror curve this one around this axis. So, and let's define the distance between these two circles. The 4 millimeters, sorry, just like this, and just extrude it. You see the extruding direction. Let's change it. Make it. You can make it symmetric extrude like this, and from the volume make it subtract. So subtract from the this surface and press OK. So we created here the hole. So for the AirPod. So now we can hide our sketches. Now we can continue with some features of the AirPods. So in order to do this, let's create new datum planes for the beginning. So select the datum plane. So here, select this one, and select, you can drag this one and define the distance is not important. Just define any datum plane here. So at a distance, press OK, and select the sketch again, and select this plane, new plane, press OK, and let's draw here the ellipse here, for example, on the this point, and let's define the dimensions of the ellipse as here the 2, and measure the minor diameter is the 1 like this. So, and just press OK, and let's define here the position of the ellipse from the this position to the this position is the 5 millimeter, and here. So and define here the geometric constraint. So go to the geometric constraint and make it point on curve. So ellipse center is the exactly on the this point. So here we can maybe a little bit change the ellipse dimension, so a little bit smaller. No, this one, so can delete this one. Ellipse this one and this one, No, okay, let's keep like this. So now we'll draw the circle here. Circle with the diameter of the 1 millimeter. And let's define the dimension of the circle from the axis. So distance from here to here, horizontal dimension, let's make it 12. And vertical dimension, let's make it 9. Press enter. So, and close it and finish the sketch. So you see we created ellipse and the circle here. Now we will make the projection of these two sketches on the dead surfaces. So we can hide this plane. So in order to make the projection, so select the curve here and go to the here to select the project curve. And here select the ellipse and the circle to, that's a projection curve. And here select the surface, this one and this one. So you see the surface is selected and the vector along the, select this vector. So in this case, change the direction. You see that the curves is the projected to this curves in the surfaces and just that's okay. We can now hide these ones just to keep the two curves on the surfaces here. And we can make it here the select the surface. And also on the this side also we created the surface here. So circle. And select the surface and they go to the trim sheet. And here we want to make some holes here. In order to do this, select here the as a target, for example, the inside of the, this one. And here the select as a boundary the circle. So target select again this, so inside of the, this ellipse and the asset boundary. In this case, I will select the single curve. So I change the single and just select this, the curve. So it is selected and here the region, make it discard. So, and it should be deleted. So just preview it. You see, we obtained this element here and you can apply it. The same way we can do on the, this hole. So as a target, select the inside here. So the we can separately do and at the boundary select here, the it should be the single here. And select this one and it should be the discard here and make it preview. So you see it is the doing this one the same way. Let's do here. So apply for the beginning and select the target inside here. So you see my cursor is location exactly inside. Then the boundary here should be the single and this one, and it should be the discard and press apply. You see it is obtained this kind of holes here and cancel it. So this one is the what we obtained here. And the same way we can do the same operation on the this side. In order to do this, let's go home again, select the datum plane, the create a new datum plane at a distance, in this case, this datum plane, and the reverse the direction and press OK here. The again sketch, select this bottom plane, reverse direction, and OK here, and here. Draw the rectangle by 2 points, for example, here and here. And let's define the dimensions of the for this rectangle. Let's make it 4 millimeter. And let's make it 2 here. And let's draw the arc. This one. This one, it should be tangent like this. This one and this one. So, and quick trim, this one, and this one. So, and finish the sketch. Now, the same way we will make the projection of the this element onto this surface. So, select the curve. So, project curve. Select this one. The from the surface, select this surface and the vector direction on the this axis. See, it is the projected. And press OK here. So we can hide this one and this one as well. Now we'll make the trim function. So we'll go to the surface. So select the trim sheet. So select the inside again and as a boundary, select this one. So all you have to select this one and again this one. You see, all is selected. So boundary is discard and just apply it to obtain such kind of shape like this. You can see it here. You see? So our airport is almost ready. We can hide the curves. So this is the curves. So which is the projected curves. So like this. Now we can make some, give the some thickness for the our the element. So select the home tab, open here the more and select here the thickness and make it thickness 1 millimeter and select this surface. So select here for the beginning, we have to make some combine operation. So let's go to the surface, save function, this surface, this surface. So should be combined and this surface and this surface should be combined. Now we can make it again the, give the thickness. So more function thickness and select this one. Change the direction. Now we have to change the direction it. Just a moment. So change direction. So there's the change the offset. That's the thickness 1 millimeter. Now it's okay. You say it give it the thickness. So it's okay. So you see, it will become some thicker element. We can go to the view, make it some view analysis. So from the this side, from the Z axis, you can see, the thickness is a little bit thicker. We can decrease the thickness value, go to the part navigator and double click here. Let's make it 0.5 is enough the thickness. For example, you can give the another value. So now it's okay. You can check it here with the view like this. You see, it is the becomes the hollow element with the all the parts here. So now we can give some color. So go to the view. So edit object display, the select the whole element. So again, select two times the lower part also, and check the all the sides. It's okay, everything is selected. Press okay here, and select the color, and you can define the, for example, the any color as you want, just like this. So this is our airport practice, and you can do that by yourself the following the videos. And if you like the tutorial, just press the like and subscribe to my channel for more advanced tutorials. Thank you very much.